Today's video is not for those with a fear of heights or a nervous disposition, because I'm 9 metres above ground replacing a broken chimney pot. Now, the chimney that originally vented this old boiler had an asbestos flue cowl which blew off in the storms a couple of years ago. The now redundant chimney has been open to the elements all that time, and I wince every time there's a massive downpour and I think of all that rain going down the chimney. So I was keen to replace the chimney pot and the ventilation cowl as soon as possible, but the problem is getting up there. Whilst I did hire a big 8 metre ladder from my local hire place, standing at the top of it and looking down was absolutely terrifying. At that height, it's very dangerous to be chipping away at masonry and lugging up buckets laden with sand and cement. Option two was seemingly more straightforward, accessing the chimney from the valley between the two roofs. And I even bought this roof hook kit for attaching to my ladder for this purpose. But it would have involved a relatively precarious walk along a walkway attached along the ridge to span the final distance from the end of the valley to the chimney pot, and I decided that was far too much hassle. So the obvious answer was to use a scaffold tail, and I'd been a bit reluctant to do this given proximity to the admittedly insulated power line, but I had no other option. And it just so happens we have an industrial scaffolding tail which we bought for the business 10 years ago. If you want to buy one of these, it's going to set you back about £1,500 for the sort of dimensions we're looking at here. So the obvious thing to do is to hire a scaffold tower, and if your local hire store is anything like mine, you can hire a decent sized tower like this for £60 for a couple of days, or about £100 for a week.
A few people have said they hoped I'd show the process of putting it together. So here's a slightly sped up sequence showing you just how easy it is to safely assemble an 8+ metre tower. An important point, although I'm assembling this on my own here, albeit with my wife looking on as a precaution, most manufacturers recommend a minimum of 2 people for assembly.
Before you give me a load of grief in the comments section about the state of that wall, I know it needs painting. That's the next job, now I've got this tower assembled. But let's have a quick chat about a couple of things you need to consider if you're thinking of installing a mobile scaffold tower like this for an outdoor job. Follow the instructions. Now, we've lost our original instructions, so I looked at these from Youngman and also the manufacturer I think the tower came from. It was over 10 years ago. I'll post links in the description below, but they all emphasize the need for safe construction, in particular having the guardrails or horizontal braces in place before you construct the next level. Secondly, it's recommended to use two-way ties with load-bearing couplers every 4 metres up the tower. Now, I didn't have any of these, and so I improvised at 4 metres in height with this vinyl and rigid garden wire to create my own rigid DIY tie, and then at 8 metres up near the top of the tower with a rope tethering the tower to the base of the chimney. Now, as far as I was concerned, this was very secure. Remember, we've also got the benefit of the stabilizers, but I wouldn't recommend it because it does leave a little bit of movement in the tower, which you can see in the video with a disconcerting wobble on the chimney. The chimney wasn't actually wobbling. This effect comes because the camera was taped to the side of the scaffold tower. Finally, a pretty obvious point, don't use the tower when it's too windy.
So now I could safely access the chimney, it was time to remove the old sand and cement render from around the broken pot. I was hoping the old pot would have been sat on some sort of metal plate, but no such luck, with the pot instead delicately balanced on 2 lips of brick.
I'll try
I'm in two minds as to whether to try and remove any more of this, because I don't want to crack this chimney pot. So I've removed as much as I can. Basically, the old chimney pot was literally resting on that and that. I'm going to bring the new chimney pot up here and see how it's looking, and then I've got some ideas as to how I'm going to fill this gap.
I decided to score the surface of the old cement render to give the new layer a good bond to the old. And I'm using one of these Duro DCMT blades, as I find they're much more durable than the standard grinder discs. And then it was a quick blast with the leaf blower to remove all the dust.
Just love my leaf blower!
I bought the 300mm clay chimney pot and flue ventilator from my local builder's merchant. These are not cheap, coming to a total of £127, although you might be able to pick them up much cheaper at your local reclamation yard. So my advice would be shop around.
One other point, this ventilation flue is for ventilation purposes only, as the name suggests. So if you've got an active chimney, this is not the flue for you. That's resting about as precariously inside the chimney, you can see there, as the last one did. But this is, bear in mind, a totally redundant chimney. I'm not going to be putting any heating up it. You can see the old liner in there, which never actually connected with the chimney pot, which is a nice touch considering it had the boiler running up it. I've got a plan. Okay, this is my master plan. I've got this stainless steel mesh years ago when I lived in London to put on top of the air bricks to stop rodents getting in, because rodents, mice can crawl through holes the size of a Bic biro.
So I'm going to lay this inside the chimney as a barrier to stop the sand and cement render mix falling down the chimney before it sets. I wouldn't want to do this for an active chimney because it could quickly get creosoted up and also make sweeping more difficult. And then I applied a quick coat of watered down super PVA to ensure that the surface was dust free before rendering.
Right, that's gone ridiculously well. I've literally just laid that in there. I've doubled it up at that point, which is pretty much where it needs its strength the most, because there's no lip or anything for the concrete to sit on. And on this side, I've just bashed the surplus into the corners. And that's really strong now. And dare I say, it would stop any rodents if they were to get up here and try and crawl through one of these amply sized holes. Got to raise this up about 10mm. Not that anyone would be measuring, but I know, so it'll annoy me if I don't get it right. So, height wise, I don't think that's too bad to you. And you can see the chimney pot sitting on my new stainless steel wire mesh, and the packers just adjusting it to exactly the right height.
With the prep work all done, it was just a case of mixing up some mortar to render around the chimney pots. I typically use a ratio of 4 parts building sand to 1 part cement, which for reasonably small jobs like this, I hand mix in a wheelbarrow.
Look what I found! I didn't even know I had this, but this is going to be awesome. Waterproofer and plasticizer. I was really worried, particularly after putting that PVA on earlier, about waterproofing this job, and this will help immensely. This is quite crucial, because if I make this too sloppy, I'm in trouble. But if I make it too hard, it's not going to knit properly. So I've got to get it just right. Quite like that. A little bit more water, I think, but not much. You can really see the effect of that plasticizer. Look at that.
So then it was back up the tower to trowel the sand and cement mix around the new chimney pot.
You see why I put that stainless steel mesh on now? This would have just gone slopping straight down the chimney like all the debris did earlier. What I don't think is I've made enough, annoyingly. This is so satisfying. I'd say cementing is one of my favourite jobs, even if there's a lot of you out there who don't think I'm very good at it. I'm really pleased with the mix. On with a small tool. And I'm just kneading it down that little gap. I hadn't made enough mix, and with the light fading and bad weather promised for the next day, I made a classic DIY mistake. I'm slightly panicking, other than the fact that it's nearly 6 o'clock. I think I've made the mix, the second mix, a bit sloppy.
And by rushing the mixing and putting too much water into it, I made the job of tooling the render so much harder than it should have been, and arguably the surface more susceptible to the rain that inevitably arrived that night. So all in all, not a bad job, but I ended up with a rougher, trowel-marked surface than I would have liked. But luckily it survived the night's rain, leaving me the final job of wiping away excess render with a sponge the day after, and then raking away all the moss from the pointing, which is something I really should have done before rendering around the chimney. And the final job was to repair some of the pointing and to put an angled render bead on the brick ledge to minimise water getting into the brickwork. I wasn't sure how, if at all, to fix down the ventilation flue, but as the one next to it had been siliconed, I decided to use some Sikaflex EBT Plus, which I had lying around and which was going a bit stiff, if I'm honest, to seal down the flue, reasoning that it will secure the flue against any violent gusts of wind, and if I need to remove it at any stage, I can just cut the silicon away.
So that's it, job complete. I know it's not perfect. In particular, I shouldn't have used so much water in that second render mix. I also know it's a bit niche, this video, and might not get a lot of views, but hopefully you've learned a couple of things about assembling scaffolding towers and also getting your sand and cement mixes right that you can apply to your own projects. If you have liked today's video, it'd be great if you could give it a thumbs up below. And finally, as I always say, if you're new to my channel, I'd love to have you subscribe. You can do that by clicking on the link here, and don't forget to click the bell notification icon so you get notified of all future uploads. See you soon.